For over 10 years, primarily in his role on Star Trek The Next Generation and Star Trek Deep Space Nine as Chancellor Gowron, the leader of the Klingon Empire. Yeah! O'Reilly has also appeared in over 100 films and television episodes and has acted on Broadway and at Carnegie Hall. Ladies and gentlemen, Chancellor Martok and the commander of the Klingon Empire, Chancellor Gowron. Give him a warm round of applause.
Humans. Dr. Picardo will be seeing patients in Studio A, just down the hall. If you have any illnesses or pains, go see Bob Picardo, Dr. Bob. We love him to see all our victims. I mean, friends. What do you have? Oh, you have two.
You get one. Are you ready? Very scary.
Everybody action us. What is the matter? The ratings, the action.
Even the beds are getting flat.
It's the Klingons, baby. The Klingons. Ain't no Klingons, baby. We're the Klingons. Now, Enterprise is shooting. Ain't no episodes are shooting. Ain't no ridge on the bridge, so he's starting out losing. Trek without Klingons.
What could they be thinking?
Wine without blood, it ain't even worth the drinking.
If there's a problem, we'll resolve it. You kill them all first. That's the only way to solve it. The Klingon, baby. The Klingon. Ain't no Klingon, baby. We're the Klingon. Clothes on our boots. We always be in fashion.
They go crazy when they see the passion and the battle. Gotta see a little slaughter.
We are the sons.
Now don't forget the daughters.
Bring on the Klingons. No others needed here.
Gowron, Martok, the man you love to fear. Lurus, the babe, your cold and brother Wolf. Honor and glory, don't stick your metamorphs.
There's a problem, yo, we'll resolve it. You kill them all first, that's the only way to solve it. Klingons, baby, the Klingons. Ain't no Klingons, baby, we're the Klingons. Founders, Dominion, Intertricky Borg, ain't nothing next to us.
But what the friggin' war?
We out. What is this, Saturday? This is a Saturday. Earth Day is in Earth years and Earth weeks is a Saturday. Was everybody drunk last night? Is there hardly anyone? Look at all these open chairs. They're for the victims of the bar from last night. That's right, they're still crawling out from under that table. Now, of course, you all know the Warriors anthem. Especially the two warriors standing back there, I see them. They know it by heart. Wait a minute, ladies and gentlemen. The green girl, Orion.
Orion.
Are in the building.
We will get them on stage later.
Green skin and red corsets. It's our personal Christmas
tree. Showing up.
Oh,
boy, you have a great Christmas.
As George would say, oh my.
Hi, Bob. How are you? Oh, you've been drinking again. Oh, but that's okay. You're Irish.
Oh, yes.
I love George.
We were in Texas some time ago.
Well, this is when you...
I remember...
Would you remember how we got there?
No, I don't remember.
Well, we rode out. Los Angeles, California.
We ran up through, we came from Los Angeles? Oh,
Martok?
I came from upstate New York. I was going through Nacogdoches to get
Well,
here.
Maybe we met in Oklahoma.
We met in Oklahoma.
We met in Oklahoma there.
We were riding down through the...
Were we supposed to take a right or a left at that cactus?
It could have been the wrong cactus. I don't know.
I did sit on it for a while.
Well, was that your butt on that cactus?
It was.
I thought it was mine. You screamed so much, I thought it was me screaming. So anyway, we were riding down through the cactus, and we were trying to arrive down here. And where are we? Houston. Oh, Houston, that's right.
And we ran into...
That's one of those Earth cities.
Quark's Bar.
Yeah, we don't take kindly to certain kinds of folk in that Quark's Bar.
Yeah. So you got a big belly to go in Quark's
you
Bar.
You gotta have a big belly.
And I've been growing it for a
now,
long
anybody
time.
Anybody out there with a big belly, you can go to Quark's Bar right now. But free drinks at Quark's Bar. Oh, raise your hand. There's a brain soul. Raise his hand.
Well, he's got
nice.
The belly for let's Quark's
see,
Bar.
Let's check that right. belly out. Check that belly out. Let's see. Stand up here. Let me see that. Yeah, there's a belly. There's a belly. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
All right. Wait, what's that song?
I don't believe we've ever had a belly contest before.
We never have.
I don't believe that's ever happened.
I don't know. We might be able to come in third or fourth.
I know. I personally won't have. I won't have a chance of winning a belly contest because you know I keep myself in immaculate shape.
Yeah, well.
What? Who said?
Yeah, whoa, you know, whoa. He eats cake in the morning.
Well, after the ice cream and the milk, and a big pound of butter, and a pallet of Panucci fudge. Anybody know what Panucci fudge is out there?
I never heard of it.
Huh?
What is Panucci fudge?
Nobody ever heard of Panucci fudge? Orion girls, you know what Panucci fudge is.
You know what Panucci fudge is.
Well, you know what? I happen to have some up in my room.
Hi, General Card.
I happen to bring extra Panucci fudge.
Oh, my Lord. Orion girls.
I was just hoping the Orions would show up. And sure enough.
They did.
Yeah, now why are we talking like this? Because it's Texas.
It's Texas. Oh. I swear we talk in Texas.
How that happened? Well, suddenly we're just talking like this. I don't know.
Well, we become
Klingon
Texas.
Yeah.
Or Texas Klingon.
What,
y'all? Yeah,
y'all.
Come on down here.
there's Fort Hood and a big field back there. Now, does Big Field still exist? Biggs Air Force Base?
Negative.
We took it off the map, I guess, of one of our visits. But Hood is still here. Yeah, oh yeah.
Wait. Could we get these gentlemen up here and do it? Warriors
Anthem? Why not?
Would you come up there? Now, I want you to notice that they do belong in Quark's Bar. They got Big Belly, just like Big Belly Bob over here.
Here, you general warriors, you take this mic between you. All right. Move right over here to the center.
Don't step on my feet.
All right, and I'll use this one here. You can use those there.
All right. I do background on this.
Is this kind of cord? No, it's FM.
No, he leads.
Frequently miserable.
He's the new leader. Lead on.
Oh, yeah, by the way, if Ricardo's still here, he couldn't be bothered to stick around. No, Picardo, he failed to mention that the commander of the Klingon Empire, the high commander, is dead.
Whereas I'm looking pretty good for a dead man.
Well, I'm glad you think so. Bless your heart. But that doctor, yeah, you know, he's from a different, he's a hologram, you know. I don't know who's noticed, he's a hologram. Anyway,
We're singing.
Yeah,
remember?
Warriors
there
Anthem.
We go.
I got this podium and I suddenly became a politician. and this is gonna hurt.
See what the job does to you?
This is gonna hurt. I'm sorry for those that will hurt, but the famous line, oops. Oops. All right. You want to start with a beat?
Wrong song?
That's a raw song. Right. Man, you lose a few more brain cells when you die. just a good bass beat.
I had them to begin with.
Yeah. Koi Kalas Puklone, Koi Pukbe Puk, Yamba Mamba Jeshuvi, Shemwak Tome
Puk, Yamba Mamba Jeshuvi,
Thank you.
Final words to that last verse was what again?
Vote for Marta.
Oh, well, I
vote for
Marta. Well, I guess he's right about that. So, now you gentlemen are from you're not from the Kefalolans like my family, the House of Martok, is it?
No.
Now, what house are you from?
I'm the House of Torok.
The House of Torok. And you?
House of Roulette.
House of Roulette. I was there last night.
Thank you.
Yeah.
They gamble there a lot.
Double zero. Always.
Double L's, double T's.
Always bet on that high odds on double zero. Every time, just put your money on double zero. It'll come up.
And that's where you got.
And that's why I am skunk broke. But anyway, thank you, gentlemen. Unless you want to stand up here and sing another tune, a drinking song, perhaps, a seat. You look fantastic, by the way.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
The dead one. Yes. He looks great for being
not
dead.
Not bad for a dead guy.
Walking Dead, crossover.
That's right, The Walking Dead.
Thank you. Kapla.
Kapla.
And for that.
Kapla. Oh, thank you, sir.
Watch your step.
So before we actually, Orion, girl. Well, let's just.
Almost.
For just a second.
It's almost time, Orion.
It's almost time, but we want to find out if there's anybody. Wait a minute, I got two microphones. And furthermore, I would like to pledge to you all that I will serve you as strongly as I can in the Congress of the United States. Oh, boy. Two microphones, yes. Don't cry for me, Texarkana. So, yes, before we invite the green girls.
Yes, the green
I just
girls.
Like saying that, don't you?
The green girls.
I mean, it just makes you quiver all
It's like the green belt. The green girls.
The green belt.
I've been to Green Belt.
Do you know Green Belt, Maryland? Who knows Green Belt, Maryland? Did you go to Green Belt? Were you in high school there?
Yeah, I lived in D.C. for a year.
Where?
Well,
none of that is D.C. What are you saying you live in D.C.? Silver Springs in Maryland, Arlington, that's in Virginia. You lying sack of shit. I've been in D.C. for 8 years, but you didn't live there. Well,
all right. I'm going to yell at you in the hallway and get more people
when were you there?
We got plenty of room in here. Get your butts in here. Hey, we're doing a show in here. Get your butts in here. We got seats. Now let's move it. Hey, I ain't shy.
No, this is much better. Now, you live in Silver Spring, you said. Now, back in the day, my alter ego is J.G. Hertzler, but I was John back there. In fact, I might have even been Noah. I always wanted to be... I feel something ugly over my right shoulder. I feel a certain ugliness in the air. My powerful odor of mendacity in this room. You smell it, Mark? What? There you are. Usually hides on my bad eyesight, which is really official.
An imitation of Martok.
No. Unfortunately, I can't do an imitation of Bob because I only have the one eye. But I don't feel badly about it. And I'm not dead yet.
Oh, wait a minute. If we did this, we'd have two eyes between us.
And still lacking a brain. But I started out in this business of show business in Silver Spring.
You still in it?
Yeah. I was Silver Spring Stage, you know? You know where that is? No, you don't. You lying sack of, you know what you are. What's that? No, I believe it's a massage parlor now. In fact, it was a massage parlor then. So that was where I started out. I did cabaret shows in massage parlors, like to entertain the troops while they were waiting. Speaking of massage parlors, now the Green Girls, that would be a billion dollar enterprise. Can you imagine? You know, even if it was nice and respectable, a room at conventions that was the Orion Girls Massage Emporium. You know what I'm saying? You're pointing to someone who's a massage artist? A licensed masseuse?
Masseuse.
Oh. You guys, do you do massages in greenware at conventions?
Now, why don't you all come up here?
Yeah, come on up
come
here.
Come on. We might be able to get a massage.
Let's check. How do you get back and behind this curtain? ladies, let's introduce you. And please, she has the lavender pink hair. And you are?
We are Orion's Envy, and I am
Orion's Envy.
I'm Dinesha.
Dinesha. And where are you from, Dinesha?
I'm Orion.
Orion? Mm-hmm. And what part of Orion? What quadrant?
The third star on the right, the belt.
The belt?
The belt.
See, I told you it was a belt.
I don't know what kind of belt, but it's a belt. My belt's getting tighter right now, you know what I'm saying? And you're Dinesha.
Itana.
Are you guys used to working with microphones? No? Because you usually don't speak, or? Oh.
It's now, like, I'll start on this. And
yeah, go ahead.
Mahala.
Ooh. Mahala. You're an opera singer, aren't you?
I like that name.
Mahala Jackson?
That's not a Klingon name, oh. Mahala. No K's in it.
I hate to tell you, but there's no K's in Gowron either.
Well, that's why I don't lead anymore. I missed my K's.
Yep. Mm. All right. How about a special K, this next
all right.
this next to Ryan, Envy lady?
Nuvara.
Lucara?
You can call me
grrr. Grr. Well, it's hard with my teeth, but I'll try. Grr. 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 Ah. Yeah, that worked. Ah. That's how we do it.
Vina.
Oh! Now, I can't repeat any of it, but Vina. Wait a minute, isn't there a Frankie Valli song called Vina?
Did you say Venus or Vina? Vina. Oh, so it's the feminine
Vina.
Form of Vina.
Who can sing that?
Isn't
come
that
on,
odd
you
that
can
Venus
sing.
Would oh, be a male ending of the most feminine thing in the world. Venus.
All right.
She's Vina.
Now, we've had and a special request. You know,
and what town do you live in? Vina? Vina, yeah. Or when you're visiting Earth, where do you stay? Lafayette. Oh, that's right. And your street address is? Hey now.
Come on in. Get in here. We've had a special, you know that Orion Girls dance?
Oh, yeah.
And they're the greatest dancers in the universe. That's kind of what they do. So we had a request last night at the bar when we were drinking too much. And the request was to teach Klingons how to do the Macarena.
Now, we don't know if they know the Macarena, but we're going to try. They can't teach a Klingon much, I'll tell you. Do you have any music?
Oh, they do.
Well, I could sing.
They
hey,
do.
Macarena.
Oh, Lord. I mean, I hate the earth anyway, but I wouldn't even do that to my hated enemies to have you sing the Macarena. Hey, Macarena. Oh, ah, la, 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 la. Yeah, but you're gonna try to do the Macarena? All right, go for it.
All right, I can do it. Wait a minute, now we got one missing.
Little envy, a little bit of envy. Oh, is that what do you got there? You think we're this full? We'll go through this mic and go through.
Oh, yeah, cool.
Where are you gonna take pictures?
You're gonna turn it on?
Oh, it's not the Macarena. Can you have a thing that they can plug into?
While we're waiting for them to take care of these technical issues.
What did I just say? You can plug it in right here.
I'll tell you the story of my life.
That's about it.
Oh, there we are. I don't want to do it. I just want to watch. Woo! Come on, silly people, get up. Get up there, silly people.
Work I've had all week.
And do the Macarena. I mean, if you can't do it here, where are you going to do it? No, I didn't mean that.
Whoa! Thank you!
Woo! I'm talking to you now. Now,
John, did you give up?
No, I was trying to get the entire audience, because that would be worth a flash mob, you know? To do the whole audience doing the Macarena, would it be cool? Oh, you got a triple.
Well, see? We got that triple going.
Yeah. I got a question. What do you guys do? You live in Lafayette, Louisiana? Now, you guys know where Louisiana is, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's around the third cactus.
Yeah, I turned left there one time.
And there's a cypress.
I stayed
there
for about 30 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Lake Charles.
Doing the Macarena. But you guys, you actually appear places just conventions or other things? Retirement parties, birthday parties? do you travel to New York State? Mardi Gras balls. What's a Mardi Gras ball?
It's a Mardi Gras party.
Does it have beads wrapped around it? Oh, nice. There are beads. There are beads. Anyway, you guys are so beautiful.
You are.
And so sexy. And so funny. And despite the fact that you have a triple, we still love you. And thank you for coming over here, you know? Do you want to do your own thing?
You want to do a dance?
It's up to you. You guys,
I'm not sure they practice.
I know, but and they don't have their
music.
Oh,
okay, go for it.
You want a microphone?
I get the front row seat.
Now, do you need
anybody's going to bother me about it, it's got to speak to me and him.
Oh, you're going to play it on the mic? Well, let me get the mic on it for you.
Oh, you need a mic?
Oh.
Oh, okay. All right.
Oh, you're, oh.
We're performing tonight at 9:30 in the atrium.
Oh, 9:30 at the atrium.
9:30 tonight in the atrium.
We'll be there.
And I swear to you, don't miss it. You'll hate yourself.
Oh, it's incredible what they do.
Yes, you'll hate yourself afterwards.
Better than the Macarena.
Well, maybe not the man. You'll love yourself afterwards. You have different costumes? Like nothing? Woo!
Yahoo!
What, 9:30?
95 degrees and nothing.
We'll be there, man.
All right, we'll be
there.
Thank
you, ladies.
Thank you. Kapla!
Thank you, ladies.
Woo! Oh, yeah. Thank you for that.
Thank you, ladies.
Wow.
Wow, have they been up here yet? I've just forgotten. I don't know. It's sort of like a human man. My mind just went blank. You know, there's just, what? Yeah. Yeah, you know what I'm thinking.
It's called old age.
Oh, man, it is. It's a frightening thing.
I'm there, too.
Yeah, but you're like, 35?
Yeah, about that.
Yeah, so I'm only 27.
Yeah.
My theory is you stop aging at age 6. And the rest of it is just scar tissue over that. That's why
I'm definitely, I got a lot of scar tissue.
Yeah. Now, does anybody have anybody unfamiliar with Klingon culture or have any questions?
Or behavior?
About what the heck we're talking about? Any questions?
Who the
at
hell
all?
Are we? Yeah, there's one person there. Do we have what? Mullets? Are they edible? My hair's my hair, and you can't have it.
Mullets?
Jeez.
Does anybody in the room have a mullet?
Anybody got a mullet?
I don't see any mullets around here.
I thought they were a hard crustacean that
you have
ate.
A mullet?
Klingons are like a crustacean.
I don't believe they're legal in Texas, are they?
No,
mullets?
Crustaceans ain't legal. Only on the coast.
No, I believe there was a law passed recently. Mullets are
illegal.
Persona non grata in Texasa. Texas. Texas.
Where?
How do you pronounce this place?
Texasa?
That's a salsa. That's a Texas salsa. Texasas. Texas sauce. Texas sauce.
Texas sauce. You have Texas sauce here? In Texas?
Texas. It's a Greek.
Testosterone.
It's a Greek town. Texas.
How about testosterone?
Texopolis.
I can't say that again.
All right. So, any other questions? Gentlemen, you must have a question.
Oh, there's a question.
Where?
Say them all at the same time. Yeah.
Oh, here.
What's a good Klingon pickup line?
What's a what?
What's a good Klingon pickup line?
A good Klingon pickup line? You mean you're trying to pick up a Klingon?
I just did it. He wasn't looking.
Oh, sorry.
Ask that question again.
I'm sorry, Bob.
Oh, here, ask the question again. Stand up straight.
Ask the question.
Make it clear. You're chewing gum. You can't ask the gum.
proud. Stand up like a Klingon.
Be loud.
Get that microphone up.
Klingon.
Take a deep breath, flex the diaphragm, relax, and speak. Yeah, I
should
say shoulder.
I don't want to see you, Mel. It ain't big enough.
Okay. If a Klingon goes to a bar to pick up a girl, what's the good, or a Klingon female, what's a good pickup line? Well, you're putting me on the spot here. If a single guy goes to a bar to pick up a Klingon female, what's a good pickup line?
That's it. We ain't gotta say nothing.
I thought you fell asleep in the bar again. that's afterwards, yeah. Quick cigarette and drop off for a few hours.
A Klingon with a cigarette. Boy, yeah. That's unbelievable. All right.
Well, that was a great question.
In the old days, I actually did do that.
Oh,
go outside and have
Bob.
I gave up. Going to talk now. I can tell.
Well, actually, I'm sorry. See, this is where you hold the microphone.
Not down here. Nobody can hear you.
He wanted to hear his belly noises. The grunt.
How long did it take you to learn how to use a batlet?
Give me a batlet. Who's got a batlet on him?
They're all out in the hallway. They're stuck in the walls and whatnot. You know, a batleth is the weirdest weapon ever developed, and of course, Klingons developed it, you know. Kalis actually did through a little thing. Do you know where the sword of Kalis came from?
Got little ones?
You don't?
Oh, I know, but little ones are better.
Back when the gods were overthrown on...
You got them around?
On the planet, on Kronos.
Go get that.
Kalis was climbing a volcano.
And one big one.
And he cut off a snippet of his hair. And he threw it into the volcano. And the volcano spit back out that hair as a sword, the shape of a batlet. But that sword was special. It was the sword of Kalis.
Yeah,
slightly
yeah,
different
yeah.
than the regular
yeah,
batlet.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
There is so much.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, if this is the end of the day, I would just turn around and tackle him face right in the chest. But I gotta keep going with this for a photo op, so.
I know I can get away with anything.
Yeah.
I can't run like I used to.
And I can't either, but I think I think I'd be able to catch you. You know,
fat chasing fatter.
It takes a long time to learn how to control the batlet, because no matter how many times you cut your enemy, you're always cutting yourself about half as many again, more times with the other end of that batlet. It's a dangerous thing to carry through a crowd. It's not good for close hand-to-hand combat. You got to have at least, 15-foot diameter around you, because you got to swing that thing. Excuse me. What is he doing? Is he sitting on my head? My friends who are not Klingon fans and whatnot, they say, so do you really do this more talk thing at conventions? Do you? It's not more talk. It's mar talk. Mar talk. I said, yeah, that's what I said. More talk.
You know, we really should make a song about mar talk.
Well, perhaps
Martok,
I will.
Martok, where do you roam? Martok, Martok, far away from home.
I guarantee you that's all he's got there. Oh, here we are.
Here we go. What, now, where? I get the big one. Okay. I get the big one. Okay. All right. Now, we're going to have a fight here. And I get this bat less.
Yeah.
And,
let me have a big one.
And I've got Mark talks. He's getting it. This. Are you ready?
Yeah!
He does.
Is this a Monopoly piece? Well, you can bite my ass. Thank you for this. This ought to work well. Wait a minute. I got a vehicle. Yeah. That's a disruptor. It's a disruptor microphone. I fooled him. And I get to say what it is. Because that's show business. Yeah, and we'll put in the disruptor sounds later. We'll fix it in post. What is that thing? It's really fat. Oh, it's baby proof. Ah. You can hit your child with this thing. Don't get any ideas out there. Don't get any ideas. That's just a yoke. That's just a yoke.
I must have thought of that idea.
There are people from Sweden here to Norway. There was a Norwegian we spoke to yesterday. Where is that Norwegian? Is he here?
Is that a Norwegian?
It was Jan Joost. Jan Joost was here.
Joost.
From Norway.
Are you here?
He's not here.
He's
oh, it's too hot for him in Texas because he's from Norway. Well, that's too bad. He and his wife were here from, she was from the Netherlands. Anybody ever been to Netherlands?
Do you ever know a name of a town in Netherlands you can't say?
I can't say it. Anybody here from Holland? Well, if you know, there's a
there's
town.
Nobody from Holland here?
Yeah, there was a convention. There was a convention
now,
in Schrijveningen. It's near The Hague.
It's near The Hague. You don't remember the name of it? See,
well,
even you don't know the name.
We'll go. Someday we'll go to Schrijveningen. We'll have some cheese. We'll have some schlager.
18 feet long for this.
We won't talk. We'll just gaga. Schrijveningen.
Well, we did a convention there.
That's for us. Yeah, from Holland. And you don't know Schrijveningen. You're a lying Nederlander.
Those are harsh words.
They are harsh. I'm a harsh guy.
I will give her this to fight you.
I have something. I'm not sure what it is, but I will fight with. I will find a weapon somehow.
All right.
And I think I can take her. She's only like 18. How old are you? 15. She's 15. And small. I think I can take her. She's a Schrijveningen.
Once in a while, I think I can say it, and then my mouth opens in.
Yeah. Oh, okay. So another question. Otherwise, we're going to have to move on to
right,
the chicken
I'm
joke.
I'm going to get rid of my fat leg.
All right.
You don't want
right.
to fight me?
No, this is hurting my finger right now. My fingers are delicate. If you want to attack a Klingon, attack their fingers. Yeah. See, they're full, totally exposed. They're exposed. Balls. Here. It's so cute. Questions. Oh, you have a hand up. Yes. But you, hey, Bob, yeah. Check your microphone over there at the door.
Check my microphone.
No, over there. You have a question right there.
All right, what's your question? Is it okay to have a question?
Yeah, that's what I yeah.
Oh, good, good. Question.
I have a question about you, Bob.
I know that your alter ego at some point played football, so I want to know what the Klingon position is on whether football is a worthy sport.
Football is a worthy sport?
I think of the Klingons, we don't have sport. It's just war.
That's a sport.
And Klingon, you know, football is a form of war, but it has too many rules. If you could find a game like football with no rules, that would be Klingon. That would be, rugby is as close as we can get.
We are not bothered by bureaucracy.
Yeah, no. Rugby,
we don't have one.
Rugby, and I think the Aussies, any Aussies here? Any Aussies?
Any Englishmen here? Irishmen?
Irish? English? Yeah. Irish here? Do you play rugby?
No.
Do you know anyone who does play rugby?
No.
Do you go to dances very often?
No, this is my human cousin.
Oh, Human. Human. Yes.
Human.
This is your cousin.
Yes.
He doesn't play rugby. He occasionally goes to dances. And he's Irish. He's from Ireland?
He's a Kiernan.
Oh, that's right. That's right. We had that conversation. Yes, the Kiernans versus the Jumping Jehoshaphats. Right? So, what was your question, Mr. Kiernan? Oh, well, not in Kronos. not on the in the FA league in Kronos. Where'd he go? So, question. So, the question was: is there anything like football in Kronos? Is that right? Well, I've often said that the Klingon raid, the problem with it is everybody's a linebacker on Kronos. There are no skills. We just headbutt everything we can see.
Good.
It's a race of linebackers.
Who is your Chinese?
Who ordered Chinese?
Chinese.
But did somebody order some dim sum? What's going on? What do you mean? Is it lunchtime?
Not yet. Who is your Chinese?
Chinese.
Chinese. Chinese. Oh, who is my Chinese?
You gotta yell it. Chinese!
Chinese. Well, that's a good question. I guess it'd be, I don't know. I believe these warriors back here are my duo Chinese. And these warriors look great, by the way. You guys have really done it. You got great robes. You got the works, man. My armor is so worn out after, what, 20 years of...
And fighting with me.
Yeah.
All that time.
We fought with Italian flags in Italy. We fought with baguettes in France.
That was one tough fight.
That was. We had an unlimited supply of baguettes.
Well, I ate his baguette. That was easy.
Question. Or else we have to do the chicken joke, and you don't want to see that.
You don't want to see that yet.
Wait a minute. Question, or is it chicken joke? You're afraid of the chicken joke, aren't you? They are afraid
of
the chicken
joke. You don't
want to
miss the chicken joke. Trust me.
Well, I think maybe you do. Yes, sir. Right here. Yes, you. You mean to get the armor made in some blacksmith shop, is what you're asking?
No, if I wanted to describe myself, you the headpiece, you know.
I will say, in Las Vegas, in the old Hilton Hotel Experience, they had a Klingon uniform for sale in a plexiglass case for how much, do you think? $12,000. And this was
somebody from England bought it
10 or 12 years ago. Yeah.
They had to pay a tariff tax of about $8,000.
Yeah.
It cost them about $20,000.
Yeah, it takes a few hours to get the makeup on, and a lot of, you got to do some molds. You have a face, do you have a death mask mold of your face? That's where you start.
I got some mold in the bathroom at home. I can just give it to him, scrape it off. Would that be all right?
You know, they say that puns are the lowest form of humor, but I think Bob takes that to a new low. Because not only they're puns, they're just not good. They're strange and indecipherable in most cases. But that's Bob.
That's the way it goes.
That's Bob.
All right.
You had a question back here, right?
Lady with the hat.
Oh, okay. Yes, that's Kate. This is Kate, right?
Yes. Just what's your favorite Klingon dish?
Your favorite Klingon dish? That would be you. I'm sorry. I know your niece is sitting right next to you there. Well, I got the desired reaction. I know that. That's the way it goes. Some can tell them and some can't. You know that number joke, right? Yeah.
Yeah, mine is actually an In-N-Out burger.
In-N-Out burger. I gotta say, this hotel has the biggest burgers I've ever seen. A huge burger. Of course, this is Texas.
Takes 3 days to eat them.
Texas. Everything's big in Texas. Yeah. Unfortunately, I'm just visiting Texas. I wish I could help you.
Really?
What's that? How big is a burger, Frank? Yeah. Not quite.
All right.
I would like to, if anybody has a couple extra $1 million laying around.
Just put it in his pocket.
I would like to get someone to build a full-size bird of prey. Just the exterior.
That works.
Yeah.
Just build it out in the desert and let it be there for centuries. You know? And leave it till somebody comes by, you know, centuries and says, the Klingons left.
That could be us on the way home. We got lost again, Martok. What's that up ahead in the dish?
I don't know, but it looks like you're kind of constipated.
It looks like.
I'm not sure, but
looks like a
that move is beginning to worry me.
Wouldn't that be nice? It's probably a mirage.
Well, yeah, maybe we fly that bird of prey home. No, it's made out of plywood. What the hell? That won't take, that won't reach leaving orbit velocity.
It's Kronos.
What's the name of that?
Escape velocity.
Thank you. Was that the gentleman that asked the other strong question that provided that? Are you with the Space Center, sir? Are you with? That's classified. You'll have to kill me.
All right, there's a question by a rabbit over here.
We visited the Space Center.
Come on, stand up. I want to see your rabbit.
They have, you know they have aliens, like Area 51? They have aliens in one of the hangars of the Space Center. Several of them look like that with the rabbit ears.
Adam, are they dried freeze?
No. Well, they're there. They're there. They're under wraps, but they showed them to the Star Trek. Yeah. It's like a space bunny rabbit. You can get them at the cafeteria as well.
You have a question?
Yeah.
Not you.
I have a question. What's your question?
Cake or pie?
What?
Cake or pie?
Cake. 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 Cake.
Well, you got rhubarb pie in this town?
Yes.
Rhubarb. I love rhubarb.
Rhubarb pie is good, but you've never had Panucci icing on a cake. I'm telling you, you guys, it's basically brown,
Panucci,
brown sugar and cream icing is the way it's made. It's heated up and it creates this brown sugar, maple flavored, exotic delight. Well, like the Orion's Envy, a lot like you guys, except you're not, you know, it's not green and blue.
All right, we have just enough time for
and red.
A joke.
A joke?
Yeah,
joke? A yolk?
A chicken
joke. That's not a joke. That is a very humorous story.
All right.
That is like Mark Twain. This is almost Mark Twain-esque.
It is.
Now, the father McDonald had a rooster named, I thought I'd tell him like Mark Twain today. You think I should go with that?
No.
All right. I won't
close it down.
Anyway, there's a rooster. And he's owned by Farmer McDonald. Is there a McDonald in the house? No? That's good.
Not
in costume. All right. Anyway, the farmer has a rooster named George. And I will be personifying George in this yoke. And George is responsible. His job was to service all the hens on the farm, because it was a chicken farm. And George was getting on in years, much the same as me. And he would service the chickens, but he was getting slow and not quite so, what should I say, manly as he once was. So the farmer decided he'd go out and get another chicken, a younger rooster. George wasn't gone yet, but he wanted a younger rooster. He wanted more activity. So he went out one day and he bought Henry. George was dumbfounded. So he wouldn't take this lying down, or standing up, or seated. He wouldn't take it at all. So George said, wait a minute. I'm not going to allow Farmer McDonald to let me be replaced so easily. I suggest we have a cock-off. I'm sorry for that. I'm sorry. Not really sorry. Have you, by the way, the Orion's Envy, have you ever heard the chicken joke? I'm so sorry. So, the farmer lined up all the hens on the farm, just like these chairs here. And each rooster took a stab at it, so to speak. I just got lost in my verbs there. What? I did. I didn't mean to say stab. It just came out. It just appeared. I mean, I'm getting totally lost. It's like Sky King. He gets caught in Box Canyon. Penny. Oh, you know Sky King?
How many people know Sky King?
Penny, I gotta take her down. I'm losing altitude. I gotta take
her
down. We're gonna go down into Box Canyon. Sky. Sky is still there. Sky. Return with us next week for the thrilling adventures, the conclusion of Sky King in Box Canyon. I'm sorry, I had to go there for a second. So, the hens are all lined up, and George gets first shot at. Did I say that? There's no verb I can use. There's not one verb available to me. Opportunity. So, he starts, the hens are lined up. Thank you, lady. that's the end of the chicken show. We were told that joke in verbal form about in year 2000, I think, in Berlin. We've been doing that joke now for 13, 14 years almost. I have never once been able to play Henry. And it's just a story of our relationship. It's always Gowron and Martok. It's like Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin. Always number two. You know Buzz.
It's like Mo and Curly. Wasn't there another one? Abbott and Costello.
But
Lewis and Clark.
Lewis and Clark. Give that man a grade of A. He belongs, he should get some notice on that depth of knowledge. Lewis and Clark.
And Sacagawea.
Now.
And a sack of something, yeah. What was I talking about? What if you were Orion's envy? Oh, Armstrong and Aldrin.
All right.
Do you take issue with that? Doesn't Aldrin always come number two? Is it? Well, did
Armstrong
I say that?
Armstrong will always be
right
number
either.
One.
Do you know how Buzz got his name, though? It wasn't until after they were launched. And Buzz and Neil and who was the other guy? Ed White?
Michael Collins.
The Irishman.
See the light?
What's that? I thought it was just a power surge. We're done. Anyway, it's Buzz and Neil going up to the moon, and Buzz looks over at Neil.
Quickly, any Klingons?
Hey, Neil, we're going to the moon, man!
That's true. That's a true story.
John, we've got a request.
Yeah.
Michael and Sarah passed away. Recently,
yeah.
And so it's tradition whenever this is sort of serious in a way, but whenever one of us passes away, they're Klingons, so we do the death cry to set a spirit free. So, you ready? Want to lead us? All right, let's go.
Join in if you know what to do. My lights are.
Michael Ansara. Applause.
Okay. No, we got, but I think we have another hour up here. I'm sorry. No, he's coming at me with a batlet.